What's up, internet? Corey Zamir here, back with the weekend adventure in video game hunting. I just wanted to introduce this video real quick. Gonna be going to the Wallingford Flea Market tomorrow morning. Gonna be checking out the Plainville Flea Market, see how the kids are doing. When I say that, meaning Sam's not likely to be there. It's gonna be the new people running that booth, so hopefully we can find some good deals there. And then we have to get some Christmas shopping done. Might film a little bit at the mall, not sure. My 400 subscriber contest is going well so far. By the time you're seeing this video, I will have selected my first winner, but don't fret, there's gonna be three more, so be sure to check that out if you are not aware and you're not entered. Without further ado, let's go.
The GameCube that's up there on the top shelf, and also the Game Boy, the
look
green
at my
one.
Baby's party souvenirs that I'll be doing.
It'll be half off tomorrow.
Half off tomorrow.
This one, not that one.
No. We'll go back to tomorrow.
Thank you.
I just want to look for $3 in the bad price.
The game's $1 also?
Oh, no, this is a $3.
$3?
There's only.
Oh,
Jordan. Thank you. My son came.
Yeah.
He don't want to play no more. He want to sell. He bring it up.
Should you take two for this?
Take it to 2 for 5 ticket.
Well, that's really the only one I'm looking for.
Alright, so we didn't find anything at the... I know, it's weird. I can't even see. Alright, so we didn't find anything at the Plainville Flea Market. And I'm about to head into the mall. Gotta do some Christmas shopping. There is a retro video game store in here. It's usually very overpriced, but we'll take a look anyway.
Thank you.
Proto Man. Kids. Another night. $30? $30? Can't put that thing back fast enough. How much are all the rest of these? $25? Jesus Christ. Do they have $20 stuffed in their asses? 15
for Yoshi.
Huh?
15 for Yoshi.
Still.
That's
just for like,
Ransom, can I see that Monsters in My Pocket for the NES?
One with a manual, but I must have sold. I have two of them. If you're trying to pick out either or.
Okay, I'll pass on them. We have the Pokemon go.
I've got a couple of those in
$80 for an NES, $90 for a Super Nintendo, $90 for an N64.
So, we got a text from Sam. He apparently stopped by the Plainville Flea Market while we were up in Manchester checking out the mall. The kid's running his booth now. Well, his former booth. It's going to be hard to adjust to. They got a whole bunch of NES games and some Sega games and some 32X games in. Sent me a few pictures, so I decided to stop down. Unfortunately, we missed Sam. I was going to record a little bit with him. Did pick up the box and manual for River City Ransom and another complete in-box NES game, Wall Street Kid, which I've not really heard much about, but we got a pretty good deal on it. So I think that's it for the day. I think we hit all the thrift stores in the area yesterday. I don't know if it's worth the stop again. Flea market again tomorrow, I guess. Sunday at the flea market, y'all. We've had some good luck here on Sundays. Let's see if we can continue that trend. Came up empty today, but that shit's bound to happen. Let's get to the pickups. Alright, let's go over what I got this weekend. Now, I kind of fucked up. I didn't film in a few places that I could have. We went to a pawn shop on Friday morning. We went to a few thrift stores on Friday morning, but at the time I was kind of undecided whether or not I wanted to do that as a separate episode. Put that as like a Thrifting in Connecticut episode. I ended up not filming at the pawn shop because just I'm a jackass, but I did pick up one game. Got Toe Jam and Earl 3, Mission to Earth. Came complete. Paid $5 for it. This is actually a pawn shop that I really like. Probably my favorite pawn shop in Connecticut right now. I've been looking for this game for quite some time. I was considering buying it on eBay for a while. And to see it for $5 at a pawn shop is really cool. Next up, at a Savers, I'm pretty sure I got some of this on film. I did pick up Destroy All Humans. Could be in a little bit better shape. There's a little bit wear and tear. Well, mostly wear on like the outside cover. Comes complete and is in good shape. I did play the demo of this way back in the day, so I know I will enjoy this game. Happy to have it. I paid $3 for it and change. Next up, Saturday at the flea market, found one game worth picking up. Super Mario Sunshine, though, for $2. Was asking $3, haggled them down. He was trying to get me to do 2 for $5. Could not find another game there that I really wanted. A lot of them were incomplete. This one, however, complete, in perfect shape, works fine. I already have it, though, so I'll be getting rid of it. Player's choice, definitely wouldn't have kept it anyway. Now, we went to the Plainville Flea Market to check out how the new proprietors of Sam's Booth are doing. We went early, originally. Did not see anything that I really wanted to spend money on, so we left. We went to Manchester, we got some Christmas shopping done, got some food, and while we were getting food, Sam ends up texting me saying, hey, they got in a whole bunch of NES games and Sega games, and he starts sending me pictures. Unfortunately, because we were coming from Manchester, which is like a 30-something minute drive from Plainville, we did not get to see Sam. He actually left 15 minutes before we got there. He picked up Wayne's World, complete in the box for the NES, and also Bartman meets Radioactive Man, complete for the NES, which is awesome. Like I said before, anything that they get in kind of twists the dagger that I wasn't the smart ant saving up my money, instead I was the grasshopper spending it on video games all willy-nilly. I did pick up two items from them. First up, we got Wall Street Kid, complete in the box. Honestly, I don't know really anything about this game. I'm assuming it's probably garbage, I've never heard of it. But out of all the boxes they had left, this was in the nicest shape, and it was affordable. I only had about $21 on me. They also had Gunstar Heroes for the Sega Genesis, which I wanted, but they were valuing that somewhere in the range of like $50. And there was another game I wanted. Luckily, I looked inside and saw that it actually didn't have the game, unfortunately. And it could be in a little bit better shape, but it does come with the manual in shape. The box is okay. It'll look fine once I put a box protector on it, and once I finally get River City Ransom, that is. They ended up throwing this in for only about $3 or $4, so that's crazy, because this is worth quite a bit on its own, especially with the manual. Paid $20 for the two of these. But like I said, anything that they do get in kind of twists the dagger, because in my mind, at least, that could have been mine at some point. I always thought I was going to be taking over that booth, but when it came down to it, I just didn't have the money. So that's going to do it for this weekend adventure in video game hunting. Shorter episode than usual. Can't really do anything about that since it's the winter and it's right before Christmas, and I don't get another paycheck until after Christmas. So what I have now is what I gotta finish my Christmas shopping with. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what you got this week, and also be sure to check out my 400 subscriber contest, which is still going on. By the time you see this, we will have drawn the first winner on Friday. So be sure to congratulate them, and on that video, make sure to get your entry in, especially if it's going to be your second entry, because that just increases your chances of winning the next game. Like, comment, subscribe, and as always, keep it real, Internet.